The concern by food rights activists comes ahead of the World Food Safety Day, scheduled on 7th of this month. Speaking to journalists today in Kampala, they made an alarm over the high levels of aflatoxins in the local samples of food like maize and groundnuts. The campaign against high levels of aflatoxins is aimed at creating awareness about this poison and training all stakeholders in the value food chain, right from the farm to the final consumer, on how to handle food to avoid aflatoxin contamination. Agnes Chirabo, the executive director of Food Rights Alliance, has asked the government to regulate places where schools buy food.
When millions of tons of maize were rejected in Kenya for containing higher levels of aflatoxins, where was that maize destroyed from? Where was it incinerated from? We ate it. You children ate it in school. You ate it, we all ate it. Now of recent, another millions of tons were rejected in southern Sudan. Where was it incinerated from? It is the food that is going to be served to our children. That is why the aflatoxin levels are very high when it comes to school feeding.
According to Chirabo, before anyone thinks about how much the food costs, they should first be bothered about its safety.
I don't even know why we are shouting at anyone when the issues of food safety are personal. You get sick alone, you die alone, perhaps your relatives mourn, and others come for burial. If nothing is done, if business continues as usual today in Uganda, we are not only losing the trade volumes, we are not only creating another imbalance, we are shifting another cost. If our maize is rejected in among our neighbors, who we predominantly feed, then that's a signal that the pigs are the next ones to reject our maize.
A recent study carried out in the country found out that aflatoxins exposure contributed to 16% of stunting among the children. They are now calling upon the government to pay attention to several issues that are causing food safety policies and initiatives to fall short.
Both the National Organic Agriculture Policy to promote organic farming practices, the use of natural pest control methods, advancing the agroecology and minimize the use of agrochemicals. There is also a need to enhance public awareness on the health and environment risks associated with the excessive use of agrochemicals. Enforcing Section 18 of the Agriculture Chemicals Control Act 2007, which provides for regulation of the use of transport, storage, advertisement, and disposal of pesticides.
Aflatoxins are poisonous substances produced by molds when they infest produce that is not well dried. High levels of aflatoxins contaminate food like cereals, legumes, oil crops, among others, posing a serious health threat to humans and livestock. According to research, consuming foods with high aflatoxin levels increases the risk of contracting liver cancer and other related diseases that could eventually lead to death. Besides health, high aflatoxin levels are a major barrier to the exportation of Uganda's agriculture produce to East African region and internationally. Jaliet Namwaya for the news.